again. I know I need your testimony, because if you have been listening to what I'm saying and you have been praying and seeking the face of the Lord, I need you to send me an SMS. I need you to send me an SMS, because I know Jesus Christ is real. Jesus Christ is true. Jesus Christ is everything. He's the voice of God to us today. He's the one that can better our life. He's the one that satisfies all our desires and make us to be in fellowship with the Father. Now, I need to send me an SMS for what Jesus Christ has been doing in your life. I need to write me. If you need to write, write. Send me an email. You can see my email address on the screen. Send me an email. Give me your testimony of what Jesus has done in your life. When you pray, when you repent and turn to Him and genuinely and sincerely invite Him to your heart. Today, allow me to talk to you about the Lordship of Jesus Christ. His Lordship. Now, there are a lot of people that allow other laws in their life. But we should dethrone other laws and make Jesus the only Lord of our life. Oftentimes we hear preachers say, accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Now they mix a lot of things together. I've seen people that accept Jesus Christ as their Savior, but they have not accepted Him as a Lord of their life. And the Lordship of Christ is very, very crucial. Now, if you read your Bible in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 26, it says that, O God, other lords have had dominion over us. And that's the truth. Other lords, they rule, they dominate, and they permeate the time and the life of people. But Jesus Christ is not only a Savior, He's also a Lord of our life. And His own Lordship is not going to oppress us. It's not going to destroy us. It's not going to make us what we don't want. But He will lead our life in the right way and to do the right thing. He will lead our life to please the Lord, so that the mercies and the graces of God can be abundant in our life. Because Jesus Christ in His own says, the thief does not come but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. As a Lord, is the one that gives us abundant life, abundance in every area of our life. He satisfies all human needs and human desire. The Lordship of Jesus Christ is very crucial. The Lordship of Christ is important. It must be the Lord of your choices. What you choose, the choice you make, it matters much more. It must be the Lord of your home. Are you building your marriage according to the Lordship of Christ? Is it the one that chose your husband? Is it the one that chose your wife? Have you brought Christ to that home? Or what are you? Who is taking the decision? Whose voices are you listening to in that home? If Jesus is the Lord of your life, you must listen to His voices. You don't listen to the voice of the flesh. You don't listen to the voice of Satan. You don't listen to the voice of prophet. You listen to the voice of Jesus Christ. Because He is the only one that will never misdirect us, that will not lead us astray. You don't lead to counseling that will drive you away from God. Counseling that will send you into immorality, that will send you into occultism, and send you into ungodliness and unrighteousness, into stealing and robbing and violence and maiming and destroying the life of others. Those are that. When you do that and you still say you are a Christian, then Christ has not become the Lord of your life. When Christ is the Lord of your life, you allow His Lordship in whatever you walk, in your home, in your services, in your actions, in your words. He's the Lord of your body. He's the Lord of your pocket. He's the Lord of your dresses. If Christ is the Lord of your life, the work you do must not destroy others. Rather, it must add value to others. When Christ is the Lord of your life, truly, you make Jesus the Lord of your life. He must be Lord of every area. You can't compartmentalize your life and say, hey, Jesus, I give you this area. I can't give you this area. Then you have not accepted Him as the Lord of your life. When you make Jesus the Lord of your life, he takes control of everything. For example, I don't want to be a preacher. I don't want to be a pastor. I wanted to be a salesman. I wanted to be a lawyer. I wanted to be this. I wanted to be that in my younger years. But since I gave my life to Christ, He started directing, and I made Him the Lord of my life. He chose my career for me. He chose my assignment for Him. And since I've received the grace to obey Him,
He has blessed my life in ways that are beyond my imagination. Where I never thought I could get to, Jesus has taken me there. What I thought I would never achieve, even what my generations have never achieved, He has achieved them for me. That's what Jesus can do with a life that accepts Him as Lord. So Jesus should not only be our Savior, He must see, be our Lord. And as a Lord, you seek to please Him. You seek to do His will. You seek to follow His way. I don't know where you are hearing me this morning. Invite Jesus as the Lord of your life. When Jesus is the Lord of your life, you do what pleases Him. You will stay in that marriage. You will pray for that your husband. Invite Him as the Lord of your heart and life today, and your life will never remain the same. It might not be easy, but it will be with you every step of the way. And your life will turn out even much better than my own life. In Jesus' name.
This is International Church Growth Ministry with a vision of empowering leaders to grow area churches and ministries. We run an interdimensional ministry that has the vision of helping churches to grow in healthy ways, in biblical ways. Every February and September, we gather interdimensional pastors from different places together to teach and to hear and to learn about healthy ways to run our churches. This coming February, 5 to 8, we start on a Tuesday to Friday. We are doing another conference. We tap this one, Strong Goals Against Healthy Local Churches. Strong Goals Against Healthy Local Churches. There are a lot of churches that cannot grow because of strong goals. So I'm inviting you to be there. It's going to be holding at Idimo, Frank, at Orelokwe bus stop there. Please, you see all the details on your screen. Pastors, church leaders, workers, and everybody that is interested in the healthy growth of churches, you are invited. You register, there will be materials, there will be books, there will be tapes for you. You see the rest of the details on your screen. The Lord bless you as you go. In Jesus' name.